definitely look hot today.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time has come for the bout you've all been waiting for. The Fields K-1 World Grand Prix 2008 Final. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and K-1 fans joining us around the world, live from Yokohama, it's time for the main event of the evening. Introducing to you first, ladies and gentlemen, entering from the blue stage, the K1 finalist from Holland, Remy Bonjasky.
Remy, he steps onto the apron. He goes through the ropes. As I said, the moons are all aligned for Remy Bonjasky here tonight.
And the stars.
And now, entering from the red stage, the K1 finalist from Morocco, Badr Hari.
Listen to that ovation for the bad boy, the golden boy, Badr Hari. You ask so many people around the world when Badr Hari exploded onto the K1 scene. Most people tipped he'd be a future K1 world champion. Ernesto Hoosh, I know that you've said time and time again that Badr is among the most naturally gifted fighters you have ever seen. Now is his time to shine and claim the big one.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, he can show it all now, and he has a very good opponent for that. Somebody he already have, somebody he lost from, and I think he's ready for it.
Badr Hari has a look of focus and determination on his mind.
I would have to say that if the moon is aligned for Remy, the stars is aligned, and the planets is aligned for Badr Hari.
I have to say, if the moons are aligned for Remy, Badr Hari could be the eclipse in Santorini tonight.
I have to go with the star, because the moon and the stars make up Badr Hari's flag. Isn't he from Morocco?
Nice, cool.
Some moon and the stars kind of country. But anyway.
You know what? I just watched
the fight.
Finding
out of the blue corner, standing at 192 centimeters.
Well, it's hard to beat Mikey's eulogy of Remy Bonjasky on the way in. I mean, if you never heard of this guy, you already want him to win, because the hardships and the growing up poor and walking up the hill, both ways in the snow to train.
From
whatever
Holland,
else.
Introducing the flying gentleman, Remy Bonjasky.
On a serious note, one piece of statistics, because I never well prepared like you are, but if Badr Hari wins this tournament, he will be the first fighter to be a heavyweight champion and a tournament winner at the same time.
That is correct.
He weighed in at 100.2 kilograms. He also made his way to the
Is
finals.
Is that so? I thought Sammy was also a
super heavyweight.
Oh, super,
ladies
oh, you
and
gentlemen, heavyweight. Yes.
Here is the explosive.
I'm splitting hairs, but you know, I just felt like saying
world
it.
Heavyweight champion,
not my hairs.
From Morocco, introducing the golden boy.
I think I'm the only one with hair here.
I'm not splitting my hairs, his hairs.
Badr Hari, 203 pounds, 101 kilos. He would become the second lightest K1 Grand Prix champion. Andy Holt would be the lightest in history if he was to win here tonight. The final instructions from our center referee, Nobuaki Kakura. Morocco versus the Netherlands.
Bonjasky versus Badahari. Look at the stare down from Badahari. He looks ready for business. Bonjasky refusing to engage, refusing to look in the eyes of the Devil Prince as they call Badahari here in Japan. We are set. 3x3 minute rounds to determine the Fields K1 World Grand Prix 2008 King of Kings. The time for talk is over. Michael Schiavello, Mike Kogan, Sugar Ray Sefo, and the all-time greatest Ernesto Hoost with you ringside. Yeah! Here we go, the final of the K1 World Grand Prix. Who will draw first blood? Who will go down? Throw the aggressive shots, throw the heavy artillery.
The key here for Butter again is his jab. I think that's the key for him here. Because everything he throws after that is nothing but picture perfect.
Men have a lot of respect for each other. They are well aware of each other's abilities, having fought in the quarterfinals last year when Remy Bonjasky emerged as a controversial decision winner over Badahari after he tenderized Badahari's legs for 3 rounds. Hari sticks that jab.
Beautiful jab.
The best jab you'll find in K1 with the K1 World's Heavyweight Champion.
A few more jabs on that. I'd like to see a jab right up a cut come with it.
Ooh, Remy saw the round kick coming. Nice combination work. He is faster than a speeding ticket, is Badahari.
And mean intention. I mean, look at his punches and kick. I mean, he's throwing them with a mean intention. You know, he's not here to score points. He wants a KO.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
He's flat footage. I mean, he's trying, you know, it's all power coming in.
Let's not forget in his previous two fights here tonight, Bonjasky has started slow against Labana. He also started slow against Gokhan Saki and ended up picking up the pace in the second round and ending both fights devastatingly.
What I think he does very good, Remy, is he keeps on coming forward, keeps on putting the pressure on Butter.
Right.
No matter Butter is scoring or not, but Remy is keep on coming forward. Now they're starting.
Nice leg kick from Remy after Badahari worked the Muay Thai clinch in the high knee, looking for the jawline. Again, chops across the lead quadricep area.
And that's a good call from Ernesto, which what we said earlier, that the key for Remy here is pressure.
Oh, he tags him!
Well, we talked about his jaw, and that was more like a slap, and he went down.
Whatever it was, he's down. But, you know, that seems to ignite him. I mean, you know, look for Bada to be like, okay, this is not going to happen again.
Bada uses the count, takes a bit of a break, he's back onto his feet. Will we see a repeat of the Zimmerman fight here? Will Bada score a knockdown now? 45 seconds remaining here in the first round of three.
I think Remy's defense a little bit more tighter than Zimmerman's.
They both take their time.
Well, Remy is definitely fighting the right fight. He's patient. He's taking his time.
Yeah, look at Remy. He's a smart guy. You know, he's right. Like, hey, this is a 10-8 round. I'm not doing anything else.
You know. Absolutely.
Jab again from Butter at full extension. Those very long arms of the K1 World Heavyweight Champion.
For our U.S. fans, it's equivalent of taking a knee.
If anything that Butter needs to take away from this fight or from Remy is his defense. And Butter actually stepped back and dropped his hands, which really caught him with the left hook.
And watch, he just did it. He just went body, you know, head body.
Oh, light shot after the bell there. And Remy threw his hands up and said, what's going on, son? End of the first round, we go to the towels. Ernesto, 10-8 round there for Remy.
I see this 10-8 round, yep. Without any doubt.
Left hand to the jawline, put him on rubber legs, jumping round kick, missed the target. He was going down already from that left hand rain.
Absolutely. I mean, and Remy Ray wasn't even looking when he threw that left hook.
No.
And it looked more like a slap.
Yeah.
It was a Hail Mary shot. He caught him with the inside of the gloves, and the prayer paid off.
You know, maybe the problem is that Buddy Better got a hard down from Zimmerman. And maybe that's why he got down now also.
Absolutely. But, you know, like we say in the fight game, Ernesto, and you know this just, you know, better than anybody else also, is that lucky shots count in our game. Yeah. Believe it or not.
For sure.
We are ready to rock and roll. Second round of three. All three judges officially giving the first round 10-8 to Remy Bonjasky, as we thought. Second round.
Bada really needs to work now in the next two rounds to be able to, you know, get an extra round decision. Because right now, you know, he is 2 points down.
Yeah. And I think he will. I mean, like, you know, as Ernesto said, after knockdowns, you know, he's a good comeback guy.
Yeah.
Puts that pressure on him. to perform.
Jab two from Butter forces Remy back against the ropes. Remy cracked to the outside fight. Butter with the knee, and they are juking it out from the get-go here in the second. Here comes Hurry. Uppercut from the Bad Boy. Remy Bujaski forced to backtrack. They spill to the canvas. Oh, Butter Hurry! What's going on?
It's an MMA fight.
Ivan Hippolyte having to be restrained ringside here. Butter Hurry losing the plot right.
Oh, come on, Remy. Remy is... I mean, that didn't land, I don't think.
Surely Remy's not going to milk this, though.
What?
Is he going to milk this,
no,
Remy?
Absolutely.
It didn't look to be that hard to me. I mean,
no,
bad tactics, and Butter Hurry needs to be severely cautioned here.
Absolutely. If anything, they need to take a point off Butter. But Remy is actually, you know, and I couldn't really see, but I don't think Remy really got hit.
I think we need a replay, because Remy seems like he doesn't want to get up.
Here comes the replay right here.
Talk us through it, Ray.
Well, as we can see, obviously Butter's on there, throwing an uppercut, right hand, and he ends up catching that and takes him down.
With a leg pull.
And right here, none of those shots really land.
No, he just stepped on his face.
I can't believe
he just foot stomped him. It wasn't the shot, it was a foot stomp. Went right on
his head.
On his face.
Ernesto, you live in Holland. You know Butter Hurry better than any of us. What the hell was going through his mind doing a foot stomp in the final of a fallen opponent?
I don't know. I think the fact that he knows he's behind on points, he's going back to some kind of treatment.
Do you think he's trying to maybe deliberately get himself disqualified?
No, I cannot believe that.
Here's the sad thing about this. It's no sportsmanship in that. And then number two, it's just not good for the sport to see things like this.
Okay. Now, Remy is in the corner in front of our commentary position with the ringside positions. Butter Hurry is standing in the opposite corner. Now, Butter is actually smack-talking.
Yeah, yeah, he's saying, stop being a sissy and get up.
Butter's going over to Remy, and Kakuta's having to restrain him here. Ernesto, I've never seen something like that happen. At this level in the K-1 Grand Prix final.
Especially not in the final.
I mean,
Butter is a
bad boy, but I never expected that from Butter.
Well,
no,
you know what,
neither.
Sportsmanship aside, I have to go with Ray. I don't think Remy is as hurt as he's pretending to be.
Yeah, but that doesn't matter. It doesn't matter.
No,
he shouldn't have done that.
No, I totally agree. You know, it doesn't excuse what Butter did. You know what I mean? But we've seen Remy, you know, milk something before. And again, I can't, you know, say 100% that he's looking it now. Nevertheless, Butter did, I mean, shouldn't have done what he did.
Of course. I mean, he took him down like Randy Couture style, you know, with a leg pull. And
well, I mean, I think for a second there, I thought he thought it was MMA.
Maybe he thought he fought MMA. I mean,
maybe it isn't dynamite yet. Maybe he want to start a new career.
I'm wondering if it's the Kimbo slice.
The Kimbo effect.
Effect, you know what I mean, him being in your prison.
Well, Butter Hurry is ready to go here.
Maybe Butter Hurry.
Now, I've just been informed, guys, that Remy will get a 5-minute interval if he needs it to recover. Let's have a look at Gain. Ernesto, you take us through what you see here.
I think Butter is full of it now, and I really don't know what he's doing now. Why?
The foot stomp astounds me.
Well, the foot stomp
astounds me.
Honestly, there's nothing there, though.
There's nothing there, but still, you know, he shouldn't have done that.
Exactly.
I mean, that is very disrespectful.
No, absolutely. No, yeah. I totally agree.
Completely unprofessional, uncalled for. But Remy's milking it.
Oh, Remy is milking it for sure.
Come on, he barely pushed it. Doesn't mean he has to do it. You know, he got a yellow card. It's 10% off his fight purse.
You know, I thought Al Pacino was a great actor. But, I mean,
Remy is good.
He played the movie. So.
Oh, well, yeah.
Remy is good.
So the doctor's just doing a vision test here on Remy.
I mean, just on, you know, on the other angle of this, Mike, is that you have more to add to your story.
Well, I'll tell you what. See, a phoenix rising from the ashes again. Cue the Bujaski music, people.
Exactly. Next year, you can add, you know, foot stomps and leg trip takedowns during World Grand Prix Finals to your...
The horizon
list
the
of
Phoenix.
Eulogy or whatever you're going to read for Remy.
Well, obviously there's three doctors in the ring now trying to sort out and taking Remy out.
But you know what, all jokes aside, you know, of course Ernesto is absolutely right. This is a professional worldwide sport.
Absolutely.
Being broadcast in 140 countries.
Yeah.
This is the finals. This is the best athletes and the best fighters of all year.
Right.
leg takedowns and attempted foot stomps is ridiculous.
Well, yeah, you're absolutely right.
I mean,
right.
We thought we ended that stuff with the Bob Sapp antics.
Right, right.
A long time ago.
You know, like Ernesto said earlier, it's wrong in every way possible. I mean, like, it's disrespectful. It should have never happened. Whereas they're both professional fighters. They're in the Grand Prix final. I mean, absolutely, jokes aside, the fact is...
what kind of message this sends to the kids? That's what I want to know.
Well, yeah. let's just hopefully the kids understand that, you know, momentarily, you know, fighters like Butter, you know, occasionally will lose their mind in there and lose focus of what's happening. And again, going back to, the first round when he got hurt, I think his emotions took over and lost momentarily, but I'm sure it ain't going to happen again.
Just getting word here, guys. I think what the major concern for Remy is the foot stomp might have actually caught him in the eye. His right eye seems to be troubling him at the moment. Now, you can see him squinting. It's the same eye that he took a thumb to when he fought Glaube Feitosa some time ago.
So I retract my comments that he's milking it. I mean, if he got caught with a toe in the eye.
That is just what I'm hearing. I'd like to see the replay
again.
But he's blinking very heavily on that right eye.
Also, the other question is, if Remy doesn't happen to continue this fight here,
Let's have a look here.
He
right?
loses. That's an intentional foul. I mean, he foot stomped him.
Here comes the foot stomp.
It looked to be above the eye to me.
Yeah, it looked like it was to be above the eye.
No. If Remy cannot continue, Bada Hari will lose this, or should lose this fight, because that's an intentional foul.
He will lose for sure. If they stop the fight, then they quit. They count the points. They go to the scorecards. Then Remy wins.
That's correct.
And you know what? Maybe that's what they should do if he cannot continue. Because the truth of the matter is, I can see the takedown thing, you know, a little adrenaline. But afterwards, to punch and then come back with a leg stomp, that's intense.
Okay, can I just say, interestingly, the three ringside physicians hopped out of the ring. They were in front of our commentary position. Now they have all gotten back in the ring and are once again.
Now even the coaches
and the managers for Bada Hari and Remy are having their own little battle on the side.
Here's the saddest thing about this, is that if it finishes here, we don't have the excitement of what the Grand Prix final is all about.
Ivan Hippolyte is getting in Bada Hari. Bada Hari is getting in Ivan Hippolyte's face there. Ivan Hippolyte is the Dutch Muay Thai pioneer and legend who was the trainer of Remy Bajeski. So it's all getting very ugly here ringside.
And they all speak Dutch, so they can all... talk shit to each other.
To cool this whole situation down, I think the judges need to go, okay, enough is enough. Butter is actually walking over to this corner, and I think they need to disqualify him.
At this point, yeah.
Before it gets out of hand.
Kakuna has moved across and is speaking to ringside officials. We'll try and get word of what he is saying here. One of the ringside physicians has left the ring. The other two are remaining in there with Remy. Doesn't seem to be blinking as heavily on that right eye now is Remy Bajeski. The FEG CEO, Mr. Tanigawa, is also hovering around Remy's neutral corner here. I'll get a translation. Bada Hari attacked his opponent while on the ground, even though the referee tried to stop. He still continued to try and attack Remy while Remy was down. And Remy is currently seeing double as a result. Bada Hari has gone against everything that K1 sportsmanship stands for and has been disqualified. Remy Bajeski is the K1 Grand Prix champion for the third time. The most controversial outcome we have ever seen. The first time ever a fighter has been disqualified in the final.
It's sad because, everybody was looking forward to this final. And unfortunately, Butter had to not only ruin it for himself, but everybody else. Actually watching the actual show tonight. It's a real sad situation and sad to see the actual Grand Prix final end like this.
Wow, controversy abounds here at the K1 Grand Prix.
If Remy is overwhelmed by becoming the champion again, or if he's upset at the way that he won the championship here.
Honestly, I like to be in his mind right now, but...
Ray, that said, let's not take anything away from Remy. If you had to evaluate the fight and what had happened so far, Remy had the knockdown on Butter.
Oh, absolutely.
Remy was beating Butter Harry.
At the end, he deserves to win, absolutely, without a doubt. He deserves to win because of the scorecard, if it went to the scorecard. But also, he deserves to win because Butter actually just lost his mind, and there's no sportsmanship there whatsoever. And, you know, there was nothing else the judges could do but disqualify him.
You know, I think... hindsight, what really disqualified him is the post-incident antics.
Right,
he would have
right.
just stayed in that corner and shut up and said, you know,
absolutely.
I think there were at some point...
Well, you know what, Mike? If he even would have just paid an apology,
right.
an apology to Kakuda, an apology to Remy,
right,
and
bided
his time...
Right.
Well, not only to Kakuda, but to the whole crowd.
Exactly. To the world at large that's watching.
Right, which he can do in his post-fight press conference, but at the time he should have just stayed there quiet in the corner
right.
and let them, you know, let him figure out what's going to happen. But, you know, he's walking around and talking trash to Remy, his corner. You know, this is too much.
I am absolutely astounded, folks. As I said, my sixth K1 Grand Prix I've commentated live. Ernesto, you've been there from the start, right? You've almost been there that long. We have never seen anything like this, especially in the biggest matchup of your life. And you throw it away with sheer stupidity.
Frustration.
It really is crazy. And it really is really, really sad. Not only for the audience, but for Butter, because he's such a great talent. And it's sad to see that side of him. And to see the actual fight end like that. And as we can see, it's still going on.
Well, it's still going on in center ring here. Butter Harry is trying to have words over the very loud music here at Remy. They really need to get Butter Harry and his crew out of the ring.
Absolutely.
And let Remy enjoy his moment
right.
as the K1 Grand Prix
right,
champion
right.
for a third time. Melvin Manoff there having words with Butter Harry. Remy's shaking his head. And look at Butter, he refuses to bunch. Still staring down, Remy. I would love to get inside the mind of Butter Harry right now and just wonder what the hell he is thinking.
Well, I mean, you know, it's childish, it's amateurish, it's silly. In every way possible, like Ernesto said, it's wrong. And it's sad, again, I can't stop saying that. It's very, very sad for the actual Grand Prix tournament to end the way it did.
And let's just say, folks, and I think we'll all agree with the decision that Kakuta made in the end to disqualify Butter. K1 is about the elite of the elite.
Absolutely.
It's about samurai spirit. It's about sportsmanship.
Absolutely.
And those are the two things that Butter Harry did not display amongst many others here tonight. And quite rightfully, he has been disqualified.
I totally agree. And again, you know, it's sad also, you know, and Remy's obviously quite sad also and upset that it had to end that way as well. But nevertheless, Remy is our current champion right now.
I have finally ushered Butter Harry backstage here.
So let's focus on the positives right now, which is Remy, and he's the current champion. And I'm sure that we'll see him come back stronger, and I hope that his eyes are okay. And hopefully that the next
absolutely. You know what? I agree. I think the more we talk about what Butter Harry did takes away from what
right.
Remy just did,
right.
and that is win his third kill on World Cup.
As I said earlier, guys, if you were to judge the fight up until that point, Remy had the knockdown. Remy was beating Butter.
Right.
Remy was beating Butter. And, so you can't take anything away of the decision of the referee. And so you can't take anything away of Remy's victory. He just won the fight.
Absolutely.
And, it was clear that he was ahead of point after a round and a half. And yeah, it was just stupid what Butter did.
Exactly.
Remy Van Justice will be officially crowned in just a few moments' time as the three-time K1 World Grand Prix champion. The belt he last held in 2004. 4 years later, Remy Van Justice is once again the holder of the most coveted fight belt on the entire planet. It happened in controversial fashion, but as we said, take nothing away from Bonjasky, a thrilling knockdown on Butter Harry, and up until the point of disqualification, Bonjasky was effectively beating the K1 World Heavyweight Champion, Bada Hari. Mr. Tanikawa about to present Remy Bonjasky with the crown. He now joins Peter Ertz as the three-time champion and also Semi Schilt as a three-time K1 champion. And there's only one man who has won it four times, and a record that I say is going to stand for a long, long time, Mr. Perfect Ernesto Hoost.
Yes, and that legend is sitting right next to me.
I hope.
It is all official. Remy Bonjasky takes the winner's check, which is around $500,000 these days. But more importantly than that, he finally gets the K1 World Grand Prix strap to once again place on his mantle in Amsterdam. It is a moment he's been waiting a long time for, and as I said, he's had to overcome a lot of personal hardships to make it. But finally, after reshaping his career, after rebuilding his life, Remy Bonjasky wears the coveted K1 World Grand Prix strap for a third time. It is yet another Dutch champion. We've only had three non-Dutch champions in K1 history, Brenko Sikatic, Andy Hug, and Mark Hunt. And Remy Bonjasky will fly the champion's flag proudly in 2009. An eloquent champion, a gentleman, a role model, a clean-cut fighter is Bonjasky, and he is just the sort of champion that K1 is looking for.
続きまして、株式会社フジテレビジョン、スポーツ局局次長。What
a moment here for Bonjasky. Perhaps a little hollow feeling that he would have wanted to finish Bada under better circumstances, under different circumstances. But once again, take nothing away from Remy. He defeated another legend in Jerome Labana in his quarterfinal. He knocked out Gökhan Saki in the semifinal.
I think there's like a Bada Hari entourage.
Yeah, this war going around the ring here at ringside, that's for sure.
The officials need to get a hold of these guys because
the trophy is given.
The officials are half the size of these guys, so that might be a little difficult.
Let's get Kimbo over here, Mark.
Kim, where's Kimbo?
Clean up the house. Amazingly, 20,000 fans here at Yokohama haven't even begun to leave the arena. $400,000 US is the winner's check for Remy Bonjasky as Mr. Tanikawa is about to present the big paycheck. Remy Bonjasky, once again, is the King of Kings. A victory over Jerome Labana by TKO, a victory over Gökhan Saki by knockout, a win by disqualification over Bada Hari after knocking down Bada Hari earlier on in the fight. Amazing scenes here in Yokohama. $15,000 check. And the third place position will go the way of Errol Zimmerman and also to Gökhan Saki.
I think the two most impressive fighters tonight, I mean, outside of all the talent, is Zimmerman and Gökhan Saki, because they showed a lot of, you know, different things tonight. And not only were very impressive in their second fight, even though they lost, they still were very impressive.
And you know also what? Everton this year.
I was just going to say,
absolutely.
If you had to pick a K1 fighter most impressive and improved throughout the year, we have to be able to take care.
No,
the guy
exactly.
Starts out as a Kyokushin karate guy. His first, you know, first K1 fight to his last appearance, leaps and bounds.
Well, all of our fighters in centering the Golden Glory Connection, Errol Zimmerman, Gökhan Saki, the K1 champion, Remy Bonjasky with the microphone. We'll hear from him in just a moment.
Thank everybody for coming to the K1 World Grand Prix. I said yesterday in the press conference that we want to see a lot of knockouts today. And Bada did a good job in the first two fights, and everybody did a good job. All the fighters did a good job. But I'm happy to win now, but honestly, this is not the way that I wanted to win. I was in front in points. I wanted to, sportive-wise, I wanted to win something, but not this way. I wanted to win normally, and that is what K1's all about. Thank you, everybody, for coming. I love you, Japan. Thank you.
I must say, Randy spoke very well, and that was very good.
As I said, a very eloquent champion, a very humble champion.
Don't cry, Mikey. Don't cry now.
I always get emotional at these events, Mikey.
Don't cry now.
He's not a champion. He will fly the flag proudly in 2009 as the number one gun in the K1. Will Remy Benjaski. Guys, I got to say, it has been an absolute pleasure to be with you all here tonight. Ernesto Hoost, once again, as always, the greatest of all time. It is great to be verbally sparring with you. We'll do it again many times in 2009.
I would like to.
Brother Ray, welcome back to the winner's circle.
Brother, thank you.
Here in Yokohama, it's great to be with you, so we'll see you all more in 2009 as well. Mikey Kogan, fantastic job. And folks, wherever you've been watching around the world, to all our fans across the USA for the first time ever, live on HDNet to main event in Australia, Sky TV in New Zealand, Eurosports across Europe, and wherever else you're watching all around the world, the greatest, the biggest, and the best fight spectacle on the planet, the Fields K1 World Grand Prix. From myself, the voice, Michael Schiavello, on behalf of Mike Kogan, Sugar Ray Seppo, and Mr. Perfect Ernesto Hoost, also thank you to Kimbo Slice for joining us earlier on, and our congratulations. The 2008 King of Kings, the K1 champion, Remy Bunjie.
Oh!